Thank you. I have the wonderful obligation and privilege to say thank you to a few people, and I will say it as quickly as I can. Please take a minute and read the card for those who have contributed time, energy, and effort, because they have made not only a commitment to Big Rock, but also a commitment to reform in South Carolina, what the DLC and the New Democrats are about. Ed Sellers has been one of the longest and most generous supporters of the New Democrats and reform in this state for years and years, and he actually means it. Thank you, Ed. Just a point of applause to them. Thank you, Lord, if you do that. Turnoff Silver, Lee Bussell, and his great coach, Rachel, and Barbara, who are responsible for making this all work. Dick Marcoli, former chairman of the party, Joe Irwin, former chairman. It's interesting, both former chairmen are among the biggest supporters. I think they're just the most happy to be out of being chairman of the party anymore. The South Carolina Liquor Wholesale folks, thank you very much. Nelson Mullen, who have been fabulous, all up and down and out of the firm, but a number of the lawyers. The South Carolina Political Collections folks you'll see outside of the digital rating exhibit on Governor Raleigh's career. Michelin, Americans for Balanced Energy Sources, Franklin Associates, 3DC at Georgetown, Giles Howie, and others. There's too many to read. I just want to recognize and thank the former chairman of the South Carolina New Democrats, Isidore Ward, who passed things on to Doug Jennings, representative from Marlborough County, who's got a group here. John Scott, former current House member, good coming here, where are you, John? Bakari Sellers, who is the newest national DLC fellow. Bakari, where are you, Bakari? One of the outstanding young leaders of this, not only this state, but this country. We've got great things planned for you, Bakari. And if I could, I'd like just to take a small personal note. I want to thank my family, my wife, Nancy Madden, who's back in the back, who, as of about 25 years tomorrow, has put up with more stuff than any woman ought to have to. Thank you. And my children, they did live and put up almost as much stuff as my wife. To Tunkey, who everything is a partnership in life. Tunkey has done great things for the city. I appreciate it. Way back when you were on the board. And last, I want to thank Governor Raleigh for something he didn't do. You've heard tonight all the great things he's done, and there's lots more. I've said for years, I think he's the greatest governor South Carolina's had since John Rutledge in 1790s. But what he didn't do, I think, is equally important. Dwight Drake and I were talking when we were planning this event, and we were talking about looking back on his career, and in 30 years, 35 years, not one time was there a news story, or an article, or somebody saying Dick Riley did this, and there was this favoritism, and there was this financial bad, and there was this buddy deal over here. Not once in 35 years did that happen. Not once. All the way through the times in the state senate, but when South Carolina was in its most brutal, racist politics, and it was Young Turks, not once. And as governor, during the era of Lee Atwater and that unfortunate style of politics, not once. And in Washington, D.C., the shark pit that was, 8 years and not once. A philosopher once said, home is where they know when you're born and they're happy. They know when you die and they're sad. And they're proud when you do something good in between. Governor, you always made us proud. Thank you.